फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल एसएम लेक्चर सीरीज। योर ओनली स्टॉप टू गेट ऑल द नॉलेज ऑफ फाइनाइट एलिमेंट एनालिसिस, कैडकैम, सीएई एंड मेनी अदर सब्जेक्ट्स। ऑल्सो योर वन स्टॉप डेस्टिनेशन टू लर्न सॉफ्टवेयर्स लाइक सॉलिड वर्क्स, मास्टर कैम, ऑटोडेस्क फ्यूजन 360 एंड मेनी मोर टू कम। प्लीज डू लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल टू स्टे अपडेटेड विद द लेटेस्ट नॉलेज। थैंक यू। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू फाइनाइट एलिमेंट एनालिसिस लेक्चर सीरीज। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी एन एप्लीकेशन ऑफ फाइनाइट एलिमेंट एनालिसिस टू वन डायमेंशनल हीट ट्रांसफर प्रॉब्लम। ओके, सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। So solve the following differential equation for temperature distribution over fin. So this is the given differential equation where Ka d2 theta by dx square minus hp theta equal to 0. So theta is a temperature difference, Tx minus T infinity, where Tx is a temperature, okay, at a distance, okay, in the rod or fin, and T infinity is a ambient temperature. So these are the boundary conditions which we know. So when the x value is 0, so at one end of the fin or rod, the temperature is 500 degrees Celsius, and at the opposite end of the rod or the fin, the temperature is 200 degrees Celsius. So we have been told to use Rayleigh-Ritz method mapped over general element and taking the Lagrange's linear shape functions with three linear elements, okay, to solve this problem. So the first thing is we'll have to first form the element matrix equation using this equation, okay, differential equation, and then we will be taking three linear elements to solve the equations, and these are the given conditions given. So thermal conductivity, heat transfer, conduction heat transfer coefficient K is given, then heat transfer coefficient for convection is given, or convective heat transfer coefficient is given. The diameter of the fin, the length of the fin, and the ambient temperature is given. So this is the condition that eventually turns up. So this is the T infinity is the ambient temperature, which will be present all over. Okay, so since it's a fin, so I have mentioned over here the fin will come from a base surface, let's say like an engine block. Okay, so fin acts as an extended surface which increases the area drastically for heat transfer to happen. Okay, now even though we are saying over here the extended area, okay, where convection phenomena will also be experienced, but we will be only interested to find out the conduction heat transfer that is happening in the rod, okay, in the rod of fin. So that is what the problem says. So this is the theta at x equal to 0, which eventually is T0, that is T0 is the temperature at this x equal to 0, okay, that is how it is written, minus T infinity. So it is basically T minus T infinity is 500. So if I have to find the value at this particular point, okay, the left end of the rod, okay, it will be 500 minus, it is going to be the 500 plus basically the 30, okay, 500 plus 30. So it is T0 minus 30 equal to 500. So T0 is going to be 530 basically. And same happens on the left end as well. Okay, so the temperature at the surrounding, okay, will eventually be added into this. Or here it is like 200 minus T infinity, or in fact it cannot be 200 minus T infinity, it is only going to be 200 over here. Yeah, if I have to actually find the temperature, then the temperature at the left end, or the temperature at x equal to L, is going to be 200 plus T infinity, okay, in this particular case. So I hope this is clear. Then we come to this equation. Okay, we'll try to formulate this equation in a manner which is known to us. So what we will do is, okay, we will take out the theta, which is given as Tx minus T infinity. Okay, we'll put it back into this equation. So K A d2 theta by dx square minus HP theta equal to 0. Okay, and what I will write is theta as Tx minus T infinity. Okay, theta as Tx minus T infinity. So now Tx is the field variable over here. Okay, T infinity happens to be the ambient temperature, which is constant. So if I have to differentiate Tx twice, okay, then I get d2 Tx by dx square. If I differentiate constant twice, I will get zero. Okay, so this T infinity will go out of the differential term and will produce zero. So eventually I will retain, okay, here also I will be using theta as Tx minus T infinity. So I will multiply HP Tx plus HP T infinity equal to zero. So since I have a minus sign outside, so minus sign I have taken inside and open the bracket. So I will have Ka dt d2 Tx by dx square minus of HP Tx plus of HP T infinity equal to zero. Now we will apply the weighted integral form. So weighted integral form, we will take a weight function and multiply it inside the we will multiply it with the terms of the differential equations and integrate over the domain. Okay, so I will separate out the terms for simplicity. So wi multiplied by ka d2 tx by dx square, okay, the whole in the integration over the domain minus integration over the domain wi multiplied by hp tx dx plus integration over the domain wi multiplied by hp t infinity equal to 0. Now you need to notice here this hp t infinity is going to give me a constant term. Okay, it doesn't involve any variable term like tx. Okay, this involves a variable term, so hp will go out of the integration because that is a constant. This ka is also constant, so that will also go out of the integration at some point. Now we will apply the integration by parts. Okay, how we select the terms, my u in integration by parts is always going to be my weight function, and in order to select v, I will be only selecting the term which is having a highest differential order. So in this, the highest differential order is this term, so I will select that as v, and I will apply the weak formulation. So I will perform integration by parts and try to simplify. So the first term will readily come out of the integration. So wi ka dt dtx by dx, okay, it is out of the integration, so I am only applying limits, minus the bigger integral ka dwi by dx multiplied by dtx by dx dx, minus this term, okay, as it is, minus these two terms as it is. So now we will adjust. Okay, so this is having positive sign, in fact this is also having positive sign, so this we will keep on the right hand side and this we will take on the opposite side. Okay, this we will take on the opposite side. So eventually when we simplify again, okay, I have ka integration over the domain dwi by dx dtx by dx dx plus hp integration over the domain wi multiplied by tx dx is equal to these two terms. Okay, so this term we know that it gives us readily the secondary variable. Okay, plus hp t infinity integration over the domain wi dx. Okay, now we will go into the element analysis. So we will select a local coordinate system, and since we are dealing with a thermal field, so the primary variables are going to be temperature. So temperature at node 1 T1, temperature at node 2 T2. Now why we are selecting linear element, linear two noded element, because they have mentioned in the problem that use Rayleigh-Ritz method mapped over general element taking Lagrange linear shape function. So linear shape functions are the resultant of the linear bar element. Okay, so that is very important to understand what exactly is asked in the question. Now we know that at the left node the origin starts, okay, or the origin location is at the left node. So x equal to 0 is my origin, and x equal to L, so L is the extent of my element, and the secondary variable is heat flow, that is Q1 and Q2. So heat supplied to the system Q1 and heat supplied to the element at node 1 is Q1, and heat rejected by the element at node 2 is Q2. Okay, so now I will perform the interpolation function. Okay, then I will also separately write down the shape functions, which are nothing but weight functions, okay, in terms of the two noded linear bar element. So Tx is given by n1 t1 plus n2 t2. This is my interpolation function. Okay, this is my what? This is interpolation function. Okay, and these are my shape functions. Okay, so n1 equal to w1 is nothing but 1 minus x by l, n2 equal to w2 is x by l. So we will perform, okay, now eventually we'll have to use these values separately for w1 and w2. So what forms of differential we want for w? So w is its first differential is required. In fact, for the interpolation function also first differential is required, and here we require the value of w and the value of interpolation function, so that we will write it over here. So dw1 by dx comes out to be minus 1 by l, dw2 by dx comes out to be 1 by l, and the first differential of the interpolation function comes out to be 1 minus l of t1 plus 1 by l of t2. Okay, now separately we will input these values back into this equation, first for w1 and second for w2. So for w1, ka minus of 1 by l, you can compare it easily like this. Okay, so dwi by dx is taken from here, so it is minus 1 by l. dtx by dx is taken from here, so multiplied by in bracket minus 1 by l t1 plus 1 by l t2. Okay, the whole multiplied by dx inside the integration 0 to l. Now the limits are also changed for the element limits, okay, to 0 to l, mapped over general element. So this is a general element limits we are applying, plus hp multiplied by integration 0 to l. What we have here, w1. So what is w1? 1 minus x by l. So 1 minus x by l multiplied by the entire interpolation function, that is tx. So it is what? 1 minus x by l t1, 1 minus x by l t1 plus x by l t2, the whole dx, okay, is equal to, okay, I have this ready term which comes out of the integration. So 1 minus x by l, that is w1, multiplied by this ka, this is not hp, this is ka, ka dt by dx in the limits 0 to l. So this term is not inside the integration, this is out of the integration. We just have to apply the limits. Plus hp t infinity integration 0 to l wi, that is w1, that is 1 minus x by l dx. So when I simplify, okay, it's not that difficult to simplify, okay, 1 minus 1 by l square will come out, okay, and I will have here minus t1x plus t2x. So eventually that will become minus t1 plus t2l, and if I take minus sign inside, it will have 1 upon l as constant outside, t1 minus t2. Okay, same thing will happen over here. When I do the multiplication, eventually I will get hp multiplied by l by 3 t1 plus l by 6 t2 is equal to, now how do I calculate the q1 value? So if I put over here, okay, the first limit, that is 1 minus l by l, okay, it gives me 0, okay, it gives me 0, okay, it gives me 0, and 0 minus, okay, how do we write this? It is 1 minus ka dt by dx. Okay, it is ka dt by dx. So 0 minus 1 into ka dt by dx. Okay, now we know that the value of ka dt by dx is what? Minus of q1. Okay, minus of q1. So eventually it becomes minus of minus q1. Why 1 we are writing? Because we are at node number 1. Okay, we are at node number 1. So the boundary condition or the heat value will be always calculated at a node location. So that is why we are writing subscript 1. Okay, so this will become minus of minus as plus q1. And that is how it gets the plus q1 over here. And this is the secondary variable. This is the secondary variable. Okay, I will explain again. In the initial part, that is when I am putting the value of my limit as l at the location of x, so what I get? 1 minus l by l, that is 1 minus 1, which is 0. So 0 multiplied by this term will eventually give me 0. So that is how this 0 came. Minus, when I put x equal to 0, so it is going to be 1 minus 0, 1, multiplied by this term. So now I know that k ka dt by dx is minus of q, or in other words, q is equal to minus ka dt by dx. Okay, any which way you can take it. So if this term is minus ka dt by dx, then that means it is equal to q1. That is how we are saying it. Okay, then I have hpt infinity. If I differentiate 1 minus x by l, I will eventually get l by 2. So that is how I get this as this equation 1. Okay, and for w2, I will be doing the same thing again. Okay, I will be putting everywhere the values of w2, which is x by l. So here it is required as dw2 by dx, so it is 1 by l multiplied by the same thing, that is dtx by dx, over the integration. Then again inside this integration I will have x by l multiplied by 1 minus x by l t1 plus x by l t2, and here I will have x by l multiplied by this hp dt hp dtx by dx. It is not hp again, it is ka. It's ka dt x by dx plus hpt infinity 0 to l integration x by l dx. Okay, so when I solve this, okay, when I solve this, now it's not that difficult to solve again. Okay, it is very easy. So here I will get 1 by l constant outside and minus t1 plus t2 plus hp l by 6 t1 plus l by 3 t2. Now here what will happen is, okay, if I put, let's say, the first limit, so that is l by l multiplied by ka dt by dx dtx by dx minus, eventually it is going to give me 0. So now this will give me 1, so it is going to be ka dt by dx whole together. Okay, ka dt by dx whole together, and we know that the value of ka dt by dx is always equal to minus of q. Now why we are putting 2 subscript? Because we are solving this for w2, so whatever subscript for the secondary variable, we'll have to follow the same subscript, and eventually this heat value will be calculated at node location. So already first node location we have calculated the heat value, now the second node location is left, so that is why we are putting it 2 subscript over here, and that is how this becomes minus q2. Okay, plus hpt infinity l by 2. So now when I club both of these equations, okay, when I club both of these equations in a matrix form, okay, I get this. So it is the ka by l 1 minus 1 minus 1 1 t1 t2 plus hp l by 6 2 1 1 2 t1 t2 equal to q1 and minus q2. Now the sign convention, okay, heat supplied to the system is positive and heat rejected by the system is negative, so that is radially coming from the solution of this integration equation. Okay, so that is how the signs are coming. Okay, these are exactly opposite to the structural field problem which we have seen. Okay, in structural field, if you remember, the first secondary variable comes out to be negative and the second secondary variable always comes out to be positive for a element analysis. So now as far as this problem is concerned, okay, we will not be requiring this heat transfer from lateral surfaces, because the value of h mentioned over here, this is just the given conditions I have written. So value of h mentioned over here is 25 watt per meter square per degree Celsius, and we have been told to take three linear elements. So three linear elements we will be taking in this manner, and they will be at equidistant, so element lengths are going to be same, so we will be having uniform mesh. Okay, now this is a convection and this is conduction. So in a fin problem, conduction as well as convection is going to happen, and that is how the heat will be transferred. Okay, so our aim is to record the temperatures inside the rod by both these phenomena, so we will include both these equations in our analysis. Okay, this equation we will omit because we are already considering convection. Okay, we are already considering convection over here, and also the h value is for a natural convection. So this convection generally we consider when it is happening naturally. Okay, so natural convection, so h value is within the limits of natural convection to certain extent. Normally the values are slightly lower values are taken for natural convection and slightly higher values are taken for forced convection. So the forced convection phenomena to happen, the H values would be slightly on the higher side, let's say 40 watt per meter square per degree Celsius or greater than that. Okay, so we have given lengths, which is for each element the length is going to come as 2 centimeter, as the total length is 6 centimeter given. There are 3 elements, so 2 each. Okay, then area is also possible to find, because diameter is given as 2 centimeters. So everything we will keep in meters, because the units of K and H are given in terms of watt per meter per degree Celsius and watt per meter square per degree Celsius respectively. Now, okay, we will also find these values. Okay, we will also find these values. So let's say the constant values which are coming as A by L, okay, if I have to find, then it comes out to be K value is 100, area we have just found out, divided by 0.02. So this value comes out to be 0.00523, and here I have HP L by 6. Here I have HP L by 6, so H into, okay, what is the value of perimeter? Perimeter value is directly not given, but we know that what is the value of perimeter. Okay, what is the value of perimeter? So okay, perimeter is simply given by pi times d. So it is, d is what, 0.02, into the length is also 0.02, divided by 6. Okay, divided by 6. So if I calculate this, okay, if I calculate this, it turns out to be, yeah, sorry, I have made a mistake over here. This is what, 0.00523, and the Ka by L comes out to be 1.57. So now I have all the constant values with me. I will put it, I will first try to put it in a equation for first element, okay, and we will add these two together. Okay, we will add these two things together. So what we will do is we will write EME. Okay, so it is going to be I will take this inside, okay, 1.57 minus 1.57 minus 1.57 1.57 multiplied by T1 T2 plus, if you remember, we have that 2112 thing. So 0.00523 2112 T1 T2 is equal to what, Q1 minus Q2 is equal to what, Q1 and minus Q2. So now when I combine this, okay, when I combine this together, okay, I eventually get this as 1.58 minus 1.565, okay, minus 1.565 and 1.58. okay, I can easily add them together because they are multiplied by the same vertical matrix, that is T1 T is equal to what, 2 1 minus 2. Okay, so now I can club this in a global matrix. Okay, I can easily club this in a global matrix. I know that I have three elements. Okay, I know that I have three elements. So this is between node number 1 and 2. Okay, this is between node number 1 and 2. So similar things will come for every element. Okay. okay, similar things will come for every element. So I will just have to add it up, because all elements are having same values everywhere. So the global matrix equation will look like, yeah, I will have over here 1.58 minus 1.565 minus 1.565. 1.58 plus 1.58, that is going to be 3.16. Again, minus 1.565 minus 1.565. Again, 1.58 plus 1.58, that is 3.16. Then minus 1.565 minus 1.565 and 1.58. So that is what I will get. Just put a bigger bracket. Then here I will have 0, here I will have 0, here also 0, here 0, here 0, here 0. So this is what my global stiffness matrix is multiplied by the temperatures. So T1, T2, T3, T4. Okay, how many temperatures total I have over here? I just put the boundary conditions, T1 or the primary variables, T2, T3 and T4. Okay. Is equal to what? For the global, that is Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. Okay, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. So this we will keep as minus, because this is the secondary variable at the node number 2. Okay, now if we start applying the boundary conditions over here, what we will get is, okay, we have been provided with these values. Okay, so T0 minus T infinity. Okay, so let's say this 500. Okay, let me call this as T1 for the time being. T1 minus 30. And here also 200 is equal to, let me call this TL as T4. T4 minus 30. Okay, so eventually my T1 is gonna be 530. And my T4 is gonna be 230. T1 is going to be 530, T4 is going to be 230. So I will have these values readily available with me. 530, 230. Okay. And I know that internally internal secondary variable balances. So there is no heat externally supplied between nodes 2 and 3. So I know that Q2, Q3 value is gonna remain 0. So when I solve this, okay, I can solve this using Gauss elimination. Since I know the values, I can reduce the matrix to a 2x2 matrix and I can solve this. So when I solve, I eventually get the value of T2 and T3 as T2 comes out to be 423.1 degrees Celsius and T3 comes out to be 323.73 degrees Celsius. And when I put it back into the equation to calculate the Q1, okay, I get Q1 as, that is 174.82 watts. Okay, and similarly I get minus Q4 also somewhat similar, 174.8 watts, or in other words you can say Q4 becomes minus of 174.8. okay, so whatever heat the fin received, okay, it is able to reject it, okay, from the node number 4. That is what we mean by these values. So I hope you have understood. Okay, I hope you have understood. What we did was we first formulated this element matrix equation for a thermal field problem, and then based on the given data, we found out the primary variables and secondary variables at respective nodes. Okay, so T1 and T4 was already given to us. We wanted to find T2, T3. So how the temperature is getting distributed. So you can see from T1, which is somewhere around 530, okay, and T4 is somewhere around 230. The temperatures that which we have got are in between these two. So that means we are on the right track. So it is somewhere around 423, and this is also 323. So temperature is linearly coming down as we are moving away from the higher temperature. So that proves the authenticity of our calculation. So I hope you have understood this. Okay, if you like my video content, please hit the like button, and if you want to see more such content, please subscribe to my channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. So thank you very much. I'll see you next time.